Hey guys, I'm Aaron. In this series, SketchUp Square One, we're going to take a look at the basics of SketchUp. Back to the very basics, like how a tool works. In this particular one, we're going to go all the way back to Select. So let's take a look at how the Select tool works, what it is, and why you might want to use it. Right now, I am in Select. I know that a couple different ways. One is my cursor is just the regular cursor arrow. That's a dead giveaway that I'm in Select. Another thing is if I look down at the bottom here and see that on my command bar it says Select Objects. Select Objects is what it tells you to do when you're in Select. And finally, up at the top on the toolbar, I can see that the Select command is currently highlighted. The top left command of the default toolbar is Select. It's also in the large tool set, so if I was to go to View, Tool Palettes, or Toolbars on Windows and click Large Tool Set, I'll see the very first button on there is the Select command. Select's pretty easy to get to. In fact, it's got the biggest shortcut key on the whole keyboard. If you ever end up in a different command and want to get back to Select, you can just tap the space bar. Space bar is the shortcut key to go back to Select. All right, so now that we know how to get into it and when we're into it, let's see how to use it. To select an item, move the cursor over it and click the left mouse button. Laura is now selected. That was pretty easy. Let's look at maybe how we could use Select to highlight some other SketchUp items. Oh, look what I happen to have here. So over here, I have an edge, a face, and it's a box, but it's a collection of faces and edges. We'll just refer to it as a box. So if I want to select an edge, all I have to do is move the tip of the mouse. It is the tip of the mouse, not the back, not the middle. Is the very tip of that arrow over or near an edge and click. It will highlight that edge. If I move over a face like this and click, it will highlight the face. If I move onto a face on my box and click, it will highlight that face also. I can also move over the edges that make up this face and pick those as well. Same goes for my box. I can actually pick any of these edges also. If I want to pick this face and all the edges that create it. So I want to get everything selected here. I can double click a face. Double clicking a face highlights the face and all the edges that define it. Same goes on my box. If I click right here, double click, I get all the edges. If I double click on an edge, it highlights the edge and any faces connected to it. So the only face connected down here is this face to this edge. If I double click on this edge, it selects that edge and the face above and below it. Notice the side edges don't get selected because they're not directly connected to this edge. And finally, if I triple click on geometry, it's going to select all connected geometries. That means my whole box gets highlighted. For something like a single face, a double click versus a triple click won't make any difference. All connected geometry to one face is the same as double selecting on a face and getting the edges that define it. All right, so that's nice, but there's actually modifier keys you can use with Select also. If I want to add or remove from my selection, I can hold down the Shift key. You do have to hold it down. It's not a toggle. I can't just tap it once. I do have to hold it down, but while I'm holding down Shift, I can add to this selection. It does have little plus and minus next to it, which means if I click on something that's already highlighted, it will unselect. Alternatively, if I hold the Option key on Mac or Control key on Windows, I get just the plus. That means I'm just adding. If I pick something that's already added, it's not going to deselect it. If I hold them down together, Option and Shift or Control and Shift, I get the minus select. This means I can only turn off previously selected items. In addition to individual clicks to select, you can click and drag to open a select window. There's two ways to do this. One is to drag from the left side to the right side. Left to right means only things that are completely within the window will be selected. So when I release here, even though the edge of the window is lapping onto the box, nothing, no edge or face is fully within the window. So when I release it, only the pieces on the ground get selected. Alternatively, if I go from the right side to the left side, anything that that dashed line crosses gets selected. So that means a portion of the box is going to get highlighted when I release my mouse. The cool thing is that these commands can be used together. So if I wanted to, if I wanted to get this turned off but keep these selected right here, I could hold down Shift and Option or Control to get the minus select, drag a box from right to left, and release it to turn off any geometry in the box and keep my surface and my edge selected. So that is a quick look at how the Select tool works in SketchUp. I hope you like that. If you're brand new to SketchUp, hopefully that gives you a solid grasp on how Select can be used. If you've already been using SketchUp for a little while, maybe you picked up something that you glossed over when you taught yourself how to use Select the first time. Either way, if you did like that, click like down below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. We create several videos every single week, and you'll be notified of each and every one of them if you subscribe. Most importantly, though, please leave us a comment. We create most, if not all, of our content based on comments from viewers like you. We like making these videos a lot. We like them even more when they're showing something you want to see. Thank you.